All right, another one with a really bizarre title, and I'm honestly not sure how it applies to the episode. Maybe I need to watch it more. Maybe it's a soap reference, and guessing that's what it is. Like you do 99 and 44 100th percent this, and then like the rest is lie or whatever. I don't know. I'm guessing that's what it has to be. But 99 and 44 100th percent pure horror. So yeah, that's got to be the soap bar reference, right? Because that's how she dies at the end, is by washing her body with the soap. So, and that would be the horror, and she made him into a soap bar. So it does. I just don't know the percentages. Maybe they said it in the episode and I missed it. But anyways, we got Bruce Davidson here from Willard, but I know him as Senator Kelly, right? Is that his name? Kelly, Senator Kelly, in the first X-Men movie. Just, you know, that came out right when I was that proper age for comic book movies. I wasn't huge on it. I wasn't really sold on the X-Men franchise until X2. That movie's fucking amazing. That was like one of the first comic book movies to absolutely blow my mind at the time. X1 was fine, but just remember Bruce Davidson from that. We also got Kelly Park in here for a little bit, and she's the chick from In Living Color. And then we got this girl who is a struggling artist, and she's cheating on her husband, and with one of the detectives from 24. I'm a big 24 fan. Anybody a fan of 24? I watched all those seasons. Such a big Jack Bauer fan. And in the first season, there's this drug bust, and there's this goofball with long curly hair, and he gets his nose broken. And anybody a 24 fan? Anyway, he's in this. He's been in a bunch of other things, but when I see him, that cop from 24, he's only on like two episodes, but of all, there's like 200 episodes of that show, and I just always remember him as that cop that busted Jack's daughter. So she's cheating on him, and he works for this soap company, and her art has been on the labels forever, and he comes to tell her, like, your art's been pulled, and she's like, all right, fine, I'll come up with something new, and he's like, no, they don't want anything new. So they get in a big fight, she hits him over the head, kills him, puts him in a carpet, good thing it's there, and her little dumb boyfriend comes up because he's begging for sex and her, because that's what he wants. He's like obsessed with her. And she comes up and they start like almost having sex on top of his dead body, which is always fucked up. I've seen that in a few movies, like You're Next and like a few other movies where people are screwing on top of their dead moms or dead boyfriends or dead friends or whatever. It's such a messed up thing. But she has him help her move a carpet with a dead body inside of it. It has blood all over it, whatever. You don't see it unless you were poking around. But really, he didn't notice. I mean, yes, I get it. We're painting him a total moron. But you didn't notice there was a body in that rug. And then he was putting it in the thing himself. No way. No fucking way. So then she goes and makes soap of her husband in the factory. She like throws him in the big vat like they do in the first Keaton, Tim Burton, Batman, where the Joker falls into that freaking toxin, acid shit. And she makes soap out of him. She brings it home. She decides to wash her body with the soap. Very Fight Club of them, selling old women, old fat women, their asses back to him or whatever. And she washes her body with him, and the thing eats away at her skin, and then she looks down, and there's an eyeball in the freaking soap, and it like looks around. It was a pretty cool effect. I liked that. Yet again, four in a row. It was like, this episode was fine. Like, I didn't hate it. I didn't love it. It was just like, there was cool things, little things here and there. But overall, I'm just seeing a trend. A lot of people see season six and seven. Anyways, all right, let's move on to the last episode of season six.